that bus service really sending a message of hope, camaraderie, and a close relationship between the two countries. A lot of media also present as always, but the Prime Minister of India and Prime Minister of Nepal getting over the first engagement of this two-day visit, a hectic visit, but a visit that will make sure that India and Nepal come closer through various means and faith diplomacy being played out on your screens, faith diplomacy in various ways. And this was the first segment of the faith diplomacy where both Indian Prime Minister and Nepal's Prime Minister jointly inaugurating that bus service connecting the two cities, two historic cities, two important cities through a circuit which is now known as the Ramayana circuit. And remember, Janakpur is Sita's birthplace, and Ayodhya is the birthplace of Ram, two important Hindu gods in the Hindu religion. And both the cities being connected, the birthplace of Sita and Ram, it sends a message that Nepal and India are with together through various means, whether it comes to religion, whether it comes to people to people contact. So Prime Minister of India now leaving for his second engagement. That will be a very important and interesting engagement, because that will be for the first time. He's already spoken, but it was for a few minutes only. But that event that would take place in a ground in Janakpur, which is just 10 minutes away from the temple, the Prime Minister of India will be speaking extensively and on various India-Nepal ties. He will be directly speaking his heart out with the people of Nepal about what he thinks of India-Nepal relationship, how India-Nepal relationship can be re-energized, and how the people of these two countries can come together. So visuals you can of course see on your screen, that historic temple, the Janaki Devi Mandir, and the Prime Minister leaving from that location, from the Janaki Devi Mandir, and will be going to that ground where he will be addressing the people of Nepal directly about what he feels about India-Nepal ties, how this relationship, the most important bilateral India has in South Asia, can be renewed, re-energized, and how people-to-people contact can help in making sure that this camaraderie remains best for each other forever. Now the focus shifts to that stadium, that ground where the Prime Minister will be addressing the people of Nepal. Then he leaves that place and then he comes to Kathmandu, where he will be first given a guard of honor at Tundi Khel. Then he will be going to the location where a joint statement will be done by the Prime Minister of Nepal and the Prime Minister of India. Important press statement coming just 1 month after that press statement at Hyderabad House in New Delhi, where the main focus was on connectivity and how connectivity can be increased between both the countries. After that, he will be going just for a few hours to Muktinath and come back to Kathmandu. Right now it's snowing in Muktinath, which of course people in North India will be really missing. But after that, he will be coming to Kathmandu, where in Kathmandu he will be again going to Pashupatinath Temple, a second visit to that important temple, important place of worship for Hindus. It's very ancient. Legend has it, it's 3rd century BC. The temple was constructed on the banks of River Bagmati. And after that, he will be addressing a public gathering here in Nepal. A public facilitation will take place where the focus will be again on how India-Nepal ties can be re-engaged, re-energized, and how India-Nepal ties are special. There's a specialness in this relationship between New Delhi and Kathmandu, a specialness that has been primarily led by the people of the two countries of Nepal and of course India. And faith has played an important role, because faith is something that connects the two people, because a lot of people from India come to Nepal for pilgrimage and go to various pilgrimage sites, while people from Nepal come to India for pilgrimage. Interestingly, the head priest of the Pashupatinath temple has to be from South India. Currently, the priest is from Bangalore. So that shows that how close the relationship is. A lot of people from Nepal work in India. The army chief of Nepal is given a general post in the army of India, the Indian army. That shows the closeness between India and Nepal.
Right, thank you there, Siddharth Simbal, for getting us that comprehensive coverage and all the details of this historic visit. In fact, a third visit by Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi since 2014, since the first time he took office of the Prime Minister of the country. He did visit the Janaki Devi temple there, inaugurated the India-Nepal Maitri service, a direct pilgrimage bus service for the pilgrims travelling from India to Nepal and Nepal back to India. Earlier we heard from the Prime Minister, who seemed elated with the welcome he was given in Nepal. He's the first Indian Prime Minister to have been welcomed at the Janaki Temple.